Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a beautiful paint splatter pop art silkscreen portrait and how to easily change its colors and splatters from a photo. The technique can be applied to any photo to create stunning, fun portraits. Before we begin, I provided a link to a brush preset that we'll be using in this project. The link is located in my video's description below. If you're not sure how to install brushes, I included a link to my tutorial showing how to do it. Open a photo of someone that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The first step is to separate your subject from its background. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, I find that a radius of 10 to 15 pixels generally works well for most images. Drag your tool over your subject to select it. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. To check your selection, press Q to make it into a quick mask. To revert it back into a selection, press Q again. If you're using version CC 2015.5 or later, click the Select and Mask button or go to Select and Select and Mask. If you're using an earlier version, click the Refine Edge button or go to Select and Refine Edge. I did in-depth tutorials on Refine Edge and Select and Mask, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided their links as well. After you refine the edges of your subject, output it to a new layer with Layer Mask. Then click OK. We want to create a new layer below the active layer. To do this, Ctrl-click or Command-click the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with white, but first, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since white is your background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete to fill the layer with white. We'll convert your visible image into a smart object so we can modify it with filters non-destructively. To do this, Shift-click the thumbnail of the top layer to make it active as well, and click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel. Click Convert to Smart Object. We'll make two layers below it by Ctrl-clicking or Command-clicking the new layer icon twice. Fill the bottom empty layer with white. Make the empty layer above it active and hide the top layer. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Click the gear icon and click HMS Splatter 1, which is the brush preset that I provided. When you see this message, click OK to replace your current brushes with the new set. To make the thumbnails larger, click the gear icon again and click Large Thumbnail. To see the entire set of brushes, go to the bottom right corner of the panel, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, drag the corner down. Click one of the brushes to make it active, and make sure the opacity and flow are both 100%. Click the foreground color and pick a bright color. Then click OK. Left-click once. Click the new layer icon 3 or 4 times to make a few more layers. In each of these empty layers, we'll add a different paint splatter. Scroll to the bottom and make the first empty layer active. Click the foreground color and pick another bright color. Pick another brush. If you want to adjust its angle, go to this wheel and rotate the arrowhead. This rotates the angle of the brush. I'll press Ctrl or Command Z to undo the last step. If you want, you can also squeeze in its shape. First, I'll rotate it back to its original angle. Drag one of the dots in. I'll undo it. In addition, you can also make the brush bigger or smaller by either dragging the size slider to the left or right, or by using your bracket keys on your keyboard. Continue the same steps to build up a few more separate paint splatter layers. Because you have separate layers of colorful paint splatters, you can reposition, angle, or resize them independently of the others. To make it easier for us to move our cursor around our document, open your Move tool. We'll place all of our splatter layers into a folder by scrolling to the bottom splatter layer and shift-clicking it to make all of them active. Press Ctrl or Command G. Make two copies of the folder by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Make your subject visible and active. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Threshold. I'll keep its default level at 128. Select it all by pressing Ctrl or Command A, and then copy it by pressing Ctrl or Command C. Click the folder icon to place our subject into a folder. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the folder. Go to the layer mask and Alt-click or Option-click it. Press Ctrl or Command V to paste your subject into the layer mask. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Make the top paint splatter folder active and shift-click the bottom folder to make all the splatter folders active. Drag them onto the top folder to place them into it. Hide the bottom subject. Make the middle folder active. We'll adjust the size and angle of the paint splatters within this folder. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out or in. To angle it, when you see a curved double arrow, rotate the bounding box. Then, click the check mark at the top or press Enter or Return twice. Change its blend mode to one of them that results in the colors you like best. You can cycle through them by clicking the top blend mode and pressing the down arrow key on your keyboard to see each blend applied to the splatters in the active folder. Once you pick the blend mode you like, make the top splatter folder active and open your Transform tool again to resize or angle these splatters. Using the same steps as you used earlier, cycle through the blend modes for these splatters until you get the color combination you like. Lastly, we'll add splatters outside the confines of your subject and remove areas of the splatters within and without. Make your layer mask active. As soon as you do this, your foreground and background colors should default to white and black, respectively. Press B to open your brush tool, and left-click on an area outside your subject to reveal the paint splatters through the layer mask. If you don't like it, press Ctrl or Command Z to undo it. Click on another area to see if you like it. If you do, open your brush picker and pick another splatter brush. If you want to make your brush bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Go to an area outside your subject and left-click. Continue to click on other areas to reveal paint splatters. To hide splatters, press X on your keyboard to invert the foreground and background colors. Black is now your foreground color. Click over areas to hide splatters. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.